There was a crying out for more of God, for a delivering of ourselves to Him. So I believe that God is proving why He is mindful of us, because there's work for us to do. Because He told us to prosper, to take charge, to be fruitful, to replenish, but He also said, be responsible. Somebody said way back in 52 days, am I my brother's keeper? There are some people that are depending on the righteousness that you receive in order for them to see the light, for them to come to a closer relationship with God. We've passed the time where we can come to church and just shout and run. Now we got to go running, shouting. We've got to let people outside of these walls behold the goodness and the glory of God. God is looking for you to do something special in your own generation. But in order for us to do that, there's a change that's got to take place. There's something that has to click in. And so when I thought about this message today, and I thought about where I would be when it ends, because I knew I wouldn't get it all done, but I wanted it all written down and see what God would do with it. I didn't know where I would be in the writing. But today is a strong day of His presence, and God proved it early. But I want somebody to come to this altar and get prayed for, because there's something trying to strangle the person that you are in Christ. That's one call. There's something trying to strangle the person that you are in Christ. Something's trying to kill it, and you know it. Something's trying to kill it. I'll let all of you come. Now this might be you too, and it might be somebody else. If you're standing behind somebody, I want you to make sure that there's a full step behind you and the person that's in front of you. If you're behind somebody, so somebody can walk through there. I'll touch you. We go touch them. I'm gonna touch you. We go touch them. Elder Taylor, come here. I'm gonna touch you. When I start praying, you just start touching them. You can pray in the spirit. You can do what you got to do. You take the front. Ron and Kay will be toward the back. And we just want to make sure everyone is touched. Everyone is just receiving a touch from God. This second group of people, you don't know what your purpose is. And you're ready to be honest about that. And you're tired of just living a life in a circle, not knowing exactly what it is God has created and saved you for. You ought to come today. I'm not talking about go to church. I'm not talking about just thanking Him. I'm talking about what I was actually created for, that I don't take a chance of dying and go to hell because I did not fulfill the will of God. There is no sense in going to church all our lives and go to hell anyway, because we don't even know who we are. How can you be it? How can you make changes? How can God speak to you if you don't even know? But it's okay to not know. It's just okay to not want to know. It's not okay to not want to know. God will give you revelation of who you are. He'll begin to speak to you day by day as you're consistent with your worship towards Him. And so now we have those that believe that God has spoken to them about who they are, but something's trying to kill it. Something's trying to abort the birth of what God wants out of your life. It could be them. It could be you. It could be it. It could be a habit. It doesn't matter what it is. You just want it to be broken. You just want victory over it in this season. Then that second group, you're trying to figure out, what does God actually want from me? I know worship. I know they're giving praise, but what specific, what specificity does God have in mind for me? Why was I wired this way? And so God's going to begin to speak to you. As you worship, God's going to impregnate you with that purpose. It might have everything to do with your gift and your talent, and it may have nothing to do with it. It may be something that God is bringing you out in due season for such this time. So God, I bless you and I honor you. And I thank you, God, for just being who you are. I thank you that you're the all-powerful God, that you're omnipotent, omniscient. You're an ever-present God. God, not only are you ever-present, but you're very present. You said that you'll be right where we need you to be, right when we need it. God, you are already in our furnaces of affliction. You're already there to rescue and to cover us in our trouble. And God, we've got some stuff that just kind of keeps popping up and kind of keeps going on. We get past it and then here it comes. And we get past it and here it comes. We get over it and here it comes. We get away from it and here it comes. And God, has been bothering us. It's been stressing us. It's been agonizing us. It's been harassing us. It's been a terrorist to our destiny. But God, we believe today that you're bringing deliverance. You're bringing revelation. And we even received this morning just the walk in your water for healing, God, and for restoration. And now, God, we've taken this walk of faith to say this thing that tries to strangle the life out of purpose in my life will be gone. That I'll have victory. That I'll walk in the scripture that says I'm more than a conqueror through him that has loved us. And God, I thank you that you are the type of God that won't allow the enemy to have dominion over me. But God, it was your mandate that as a man, as a woman in the earth, as a child of God, that I would have dominion over everything that creepeth in the earth. And that God, there would be victory as a part of my DNA. God, I thank you for being who you are. God, I thank you for my purpose. I thank you for bringing me out. I thank you for delivering me from my Egypt. I thank you for even this walk in the wilderness that's teaching me to depend on you, that's helping to identify who I am in you. God, I thank you that sometimes I'm all by myself, God, that you and I can commune intimately, that there's no disruption or distraction, God. I'm learning to thank you for these valley experiences that reveal your very character and your love towards us. God, we thank you. We honor you. We magnify you. But God, today we need you. We're depending on you. We can't take another step without you. God, just like Moses declared, if you don't go, cancel the trip. We're not moving without you. You are our cloud by day. You are our fire by night. You are the one that purges us on this journey. Gives us light, God, in the dark times of our lives. Allows us to see in the darkness, God, what it is and where it is we're supposed to go and who it is that we're supposed to be. We thank you for leading us beside the still waters, that there's a reflection of our God-likeness in the water that we can measure with, that we don't have to measure ourselves with people and measure ourselves to expectations and measure ourselves to opinions and measure ourselves to our own unforgiveness. But God, we can measure ourselves with your word, and then it's in your word that we've got power now to become the sons and the daughters, the inheritors of a great and a wonderful God. We just thank you, God, that you have not left us alone and that you've given us a promise to neither leave us nor forsake us, that you'll never walk away from us, that you are a covenant God, that you are a covenant keeper, that you are our husbandman forever, that you will not divorce us, that God, you would not leave us out here abandoned. And even God, if we birth babies that were not by you, God, you'll take it all in if we would merely repent, if we would merely turn back to you. God, we don't have to feel ashamed. We don't have to feel guilty in your presence. Because of your blood, you've already taken care of the stain. You've already taken care of everything that was shameful about us. And it's in your presence, God, that we sense your goodness, and your goodness runs into our lives. Help us today, God, to find our way to your throne, to find our way to your goodness, to find our way to your mercy, to find our way to your grace, God, where you empower us to be everything that we've been called to be, that we might walk worthy of the vocation where we've been called, God, that we might walk worthy of the people of God, that we might walk worthy of vessels of honor and not dishonor, God, that we might not shame you in our walk, but we bring glory to heaven, that we represent you well, that we be ambassadors of Christ, that we be ministers of reconciliation, that we be your righteousness, God, that we be holy, for you are holy. Help us, God, because we cannot do it by ourselves. God, that we would be examples of healing and restoration, even in our natural bodies. God, I speak your name over your people, Jehovah Rapha. I speak that you are the God of healing, that you are the God that healeth. I speak it over disease. I speak it over cancer. I speak it over bone issues. I speak it over muscle issues. I speak it over lung issues. I speak it, God, over skin issues. I speak it over blood issues. I speak it over heart issues. I speak it over organ issues. I speak it over limb issues. I speak it, God. You are the God that healeth us, God. And God, regardless of any symptom, you are the God of cure. You're the God of taking it away, God. And we love you. We honor you. Bless our hearts and our minds. Bless our emotions, God, that run us rampant. Give us strength over every habit, everything that's formed in our lives, that we do more than worship you. Cause us, God, to put you as our priority. God, help us to understand that you're allergic to being second place. You must be first place in our lives. Help us, God. Help us, God, to place you first, and our lives will come into order. Help us with order, God. Help us to walk in it now. Give us our joy back, God. Give us our peace back, God. Help us to know that you love us and we don't look for love in the wrong places, God. Help us to know that you accept us, God, and we don't have to look for acceptance from somebody else, God. Thank you. That we don't die at the door, God, with our hands on the threshold. But God, we've got enough strength to call upon your name. And you're able to save as many as will call upon your name. We love you. We honor you. And we bless you now. In Jesus' name. Come on, if you receive that, just give God some praise. And some glory. Come on, shout. Come on and shout. Come on and shout. Come on and shout. Come on. Come on and shout. Come on. Come on and shout. Come on. I don't know how bad you needed it, but shout to the degree that you needed it. Hallelujah. Come on. If you got your joy back, go to your seat shouting. If you got your peace back, if you got your healing. Come on. We serve an awesome God. There's something about you. There's something going on with you. That God loves you the way he does. That he thinks of you the way he does. I'm staying in your will.
I'm staying, Lord. I'm staying in your will. I'm staying.
Who refuses to turn back? Come on.
I'm staying in
Just sing that. Just sing that while you're getting your gifts ready, while you're getting your offering ready. Just say that with your seed in your hand. Come on.
I'm staying in your will. Come on. I'm staying, Lord.
No matter what the devil does, no matter what he tries. Come on.
I'm staying in your will. I'm staying.
Come on. Come on. Sing it again. Come on. I'm staying. Come on.
I'm staying in your will.
Lord, that soul with a glad heart, a cheerful heart, in Jesus' name.
Your desire today, if that's your declaration today, that you're standing in his will, you ought to give him praise in advance for what he's about to do in your life. Hallelujah. We serve a great God on today. There might be someone here today that has been in God's presence, felt his touch today. And you're not saved, but today you declare that you want to be saved. You want him to be your Lord of Lords and King of Kings. You want him to be your Savior, your best friend. If you're here today and you want to give your life to Christ, we ask that you would come to the altar at this time. It doesn't matter what you've done. There's no sin that's too bad that he won't receive you. We all had to come this way. The Bible says you must confess with your mouth and believe in your heart that He is the only true and living God, the one that can save you, wash your sins away, that can make you a brand new creature. If you're here today and you want to be saved, come on to the altar. Hallelujah. We thank you, Lord, for this opportunity. We bless you, God, even right now. We don't take it lightly or for granted. Come on, sweetie. Come on. Come on. Come on. You want to be saved today? You believe in Jesus? You believe He died for your sins? You believe that He can wash you whiter than snow? The Bible says if you confess that with your mouth and you believe in your heart, that you can be saved. Now what I need you to do, I need you to begin to talk to Him right now where you are. Begin to ask Him to forgive you of your sins. Yes. To bring you into His life and to come into your heart. To change you from everything. The Bible says if you do this, that He'll make you a brand new creature. And when He does that, all old things are passed away. And you'll become a new creature in Him. Can you do that? I'm going to give you about 2 seconds to begin to talk to Him while I talk to them. All right? Go ahead, begin to talk to Him. There might be somebody else here that's already made this confession and made this walk, that already have salvation. You already are a believer. But today, you want to make the Potter's House your church home. If you're here today, come on to this altar. Come on. You don't want to leave out the same way that you came in. If you don't have spiritual covering today, and you know you need it, I just implore you, I encourage you that you come on in. Don't leave out the same way that you came in, but leave out with a spiritual father. Leave out with some protection, some power. We encourage you today to make that choice right now. If you're here, come on. Come on. Come on. There's room. There's room for you. Hallelujah. We offer Christ to you. Hallelujah. Amen. Come on, let's receive our sister. Give me your name. Amen. I'm going to have you go with Minister Chelsea right here. She got some information she wanted to share with you. We love you. We welcome you.
Yes,
hallelujah. Let's tell you this. Sis, turn around. Come here. Come here. Hold on. We just want to tell you this. We haven't made this declaration in a long time. But we make this promise to you today. That we'll come through a window. We'll kick down a door. We'll turn a rock over. To come and get you. We find out that you left Jesus. Or that you're trying to leave Jesus. We make that promise to you. We're your family. We care about you. We care about your soul. Amen.
Amen.
God bless you.
Amen.
Hallelujah. If you love the Lord in here today, come on, make some noise. If you're satisfied with Jesus, make some noise. In this place. Hallelujah. Everyone that can, stand on your feet. Hallelujah. Health ministry is doing screenings today for blood pressure. Just blood pressure.
Health consultant too.
Health consultant as well. Okay. What do they need to meet you? Straight through this middle door. If you go straight through this middle door before you get to the inspiration station, the first office on the left. Amen. 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 If you know that you suffer from high blood pressure, please go by and check it. Please go by and check it. Amen. 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 We love you today. It's been so good in here today.
Yes.
It's been so good. Amen. We want to give a real God bless you and celebrate cancer survivors today. Hallelujah. God is a healer. Even if the world don't believe it. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Love on somebody as you get ready to leave. Come on, love on somebody. Come on. Hallelujah. Love on them. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We glorify you today, God. Hallelujah. Father God, we bless you. We magnify you. God, we glorify you for what you've done in this place. Now, God, give us traveling mercies. Keep us and protect us from all dangers seen and unseen. God, we pray, Lord, that something was said in here today, God, Lord, that might change our life, change our minds and our spirits. In Jesus' name, amen. Don't forget, we got service tonight at 7 o'clock. Hallelujah. Somebody go check downstairs and see if they're serving smoothies. They're not. Amen. No smoothies today.
Power from heaven. Hardships, difficulties, tears, storms. This is what I do. Boy, that feels good.
I know God is working, so I smile.
All things are working.
Even though I've been in for a while,
still
I smile. Smile.
Hallelujah.
It's so hard to look up when you've been down.
I know it's hard right now.
Sure would hate to see you give up now.
Because you're a winner.
You look so much better when you smile.
You look better.
So smile. Oh, oh, oh.
Dallas.
You look so much better when you
New Orleans.
You look so much better.
I want you to be happy, but then you gotta have something happen. I want you to have joy, cause can't nobody take that from you. I see you smiling.